just like we did before, in the last video, we put 5 times back and then we put etc password to access the password file. What we're going to do today is we're going to try to access a file located on a different server. So if you're doing this pen test on an actual web server, then you need to store the file that you want to access needs to be stored on a place with a real IP address or with a domain name. I'm doing this on my local server, so I'm going to store this on the web server on the Kali machine on the 10.20.14.203. This is 10.20.14.204, and I'm going to store my file on 10.20.14.203. So that file, as I said, can be anything. It could be a web shell, it could be a payload. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a very simple PHP file. So this is just the PHP start and end of the file. And what I'm going to put in the file, I'm going to use a function called passthrough. And in that function, basically what this function does, it executes operating system commands. So it executes Windows, Linux, or depending on the web server, it's going to execute commands related to that. So you put the command here between the two quotation marks. And I'm going to use the same command we used with the code execution vulnerability, which was the netcat command, which allowed us to get a connection, a reverse connection from our target. So I'm going to paste that here. So let's just first have a look on this. So PHP and the end, these are just the start and the end of the file, of the PHP file. Passthrough is a function that I'm going to use, which executes any command that's inserted between the quotations. And I'm using the same command that we used in the command execution vulnerability, which will just do a reverse connection to my computer. So this is all good. Now, the next step is the most important step, and it's storing this file. So as I said, if your target was a remote web server, then you should be storing this file in a place with a real IP where you can access it from the remote web server. Now I'm going to be trying to access this from my metasploitable machine, which is able to access files stored on the Kali machine because they're both on the same network. And I'm going to be calling this, I'm going to be storing it in my var www.html. So it's being stored on the Kali, not on the metasploitable. And I'm going to call it reverse, and I'm going to save it as txt, not php. And I'm doing this, if I store it as a PHP, it's going to be executed on the Kali machine. So it's going to create a reverse connection from the Kali machine. And I don't want that. I don't want to hack the Kali machine. I actually already have access to the Kali machine. The one that I want to hack is the metasploitable machine. And that one is stored remotely. So in order to be able to include a PHP code and execute it on the remote machine, we're going to use it as txt and get it executed on the metasploitable machine instead of executing it on my Kali. So I'm starting it as a txt, and I'm going to save it. And now let's just see here. So if I go to my localhost, and if I say reverse.txt, we'll see our file right here. So again, this is on my local host, which is not the metasploitable machine. It's 10.20.14.203, and the metasploitable is on 204. So how are we gonna run this? First, let me just listen for connections like we did before. So it's just going to be netcat vvlp 8080. And then right here, instead of including a file on the same server, I'm going to include a remote file, and the command is going to be HTTP. So it's just going to be the link to this file. So we can access the file here as txt. I'm going to copy it and paste it here. And also in some cases, you might need to add a question mark to the end to get this file to be executed as PHP. So I'm just going to go over this again for one more time. Including a remote file, which is on a remote server. Make sure the remote server is accessible by your target. And also make sure you store it as txt. Because if you keep it as PHP, this file, the reverse file, will be executed on the remote server. So it will be executed on the 203 instead of being executed on the 204. and I'm keeping it as TXT. This way it's going to be executed on the 204 and it's going to give me a remote connection to this computer, to the metasploitable computer. So if I come back here, as you can see, we have a remote connection. If we do a uname A, you'll see that this is the metasploitable machine, not the Kali machine. So we basically have full access to the metasploitable machine through a remote file inclusion vulnerability. Now, if we do an ls, we can do a pwd to see where we are, and we can literally run any Linux command we want now on the machine and do anything we want. Basically, we have full access to that machine. Okay, so now we know that we can put any code we want in here, and it's going to be executed on the system. So let's have another look now at the statement. So the statement says, select star from accounts where username is equal to the username that we put here and password is equal to the password that we put there. Let's see if we can use that to log in without using a password, without even knowing the password. And I'm going to be doing that with the admin. So with the admin, the username is going to be admin. And I don't know what the password is for the admin. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put anything. So nothing really, any random password. And in the code, what I should run here, we were doing and one is equal to one and or stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do or instead of and. And I'm going to say one is equal to one. So what's our code is going to be? Once I run this, once I inject this, this is going to go in here like we were doing before. So our code is going to look like this. So it's going to be select star from accounts where username is equal to admin and password is equal to AAA. Now this is wrong. Or one is equal to one, which is right. So anytime you have an or, if the or condition is right, everything is right. That's the way or statement works. So select star from accounts where username is equal to admin. Okay, username is equal to admin. And password is equal to AAA. That's wrong. Or one is equal to one. Okay, I'll accept that. And then it's actually going to execute it and let us log into the admin without even knowing the password for the admin. So let's try to inject this now. And as you can see, I was able to log in as admin and monkey is the signature for the admin. Now, bypassing logins can be done in so many ways, depending on the code that's written on the page and depending on the way you want to do it and how you're imagining the code. In a lot of the cases, when you put the single quote here, you won't see this message. Sometimes you do see it, which makes your job so much easier. If you don't, then you kind of need to guess what it looks like. So I'm going to show you another example of bypassing. Instead of injecting the code like this, the admin parameter is actually injectable as well. As you've seen when I put the single quote, the admin parameter is injectable exactly the same way as the password. So we can inject code in the username as well. And what I'm going to do now, so let's have a look on this. And I'm just going to reset it to the way it would usually look like. So you'd have, and the username and the password are the fields that you, whatever you put in here, are going to be substituted in the username and the password. So let's try to inject something in the username. And what I'm going to say is I'm going to say username is equal to admin. And then I'm going to close the quote myself. And then I'm going to add a comment. So my statement, when I run this statement, it's going to look like this. And I'm actually just going to copy it here. And when I inject, when I put this code in here in my name, it's going to inject that in there. So this is what the code is going to look like. It's going to select star from accounts where username is equal to admin. I close the quote myself here using this right there. And then I'm adding a comment. So basically all of this is not even going to be executed. So the code is going to be this. It's going to be select star from accounts where username is equal to admin. And it's going to let me log in without even entering anything in the password. So let's do this. I'm going to put my username as admin. And I close the quote and add a comment. And then you can put any password you want really. I'm just going to put number one. And I'm going to log in. And as you can see, I managed to log in as admin. So again, this is black box testing, so you don't really see the code. In many cases, you want to be playing around with it and see how it works with you. But the main thing is you want to test if the SQL injection exists, and you'd use that using the method we showed you in the previous video. So try a single quote, try the AND statement, try a true AND statement, so 1 is equal to 1, and then a false AND statement, so 1 is equal to 0 or 2 is equal to 0. And if they work as expected, then your target has an SQL injection and you can start playing around with it.